Welcome, everybody. I'm Phyllis Siegel, Vice President of Encore.org, and very pleased that you've joined to watch this presentation. You'll also meet in a short while three other speakers from our Gen2Gen team and partners. We all wish we could be in a real room rather than a virtual room with you. Being in person would let us see from your reactions when something we say is unclear or needs to be expanded. But reality requires us to settle by watching, by being with you on this webinar platform, because it's better than not being with you at all. This is a special presentation designed for viewers who are gathering in groups or thinking about bringing groups together. In our first showing, it was watched by libraries, residential communities, an alumni group, and Encore Network groups who were watching from over 10 states. In addition to this presentation, we have sent each of you a facilitator's guide suggesting how you could host a discussion after the presentation is done. Our goal in the next 30 minutes is for you to understand why the summer months are so important for kids and to hear how you can become part of the solution to the problem created when school is out. We hope you'll come away wanting to be a problem solver and to engage others with you in being problem solvers too. Now that's a tall order for a half an hour, and we expect that this short presentation will leave you with questions. Please jot them down, or if you'd like, chat them in. At the end, we will answer as many as time allows, and we will follow up with you afterwards so that you can receive answers to them all. While our focus today is on summer, the Gen2Gen Summer Challenge, I want to begin with a bit of context by explaining that this is part of a campaign to mobilize adults in the second half of life to make a difference for our future. Our aim is to achieve five things in the next 5 years: to mobilize 1 million people who believe that adults over 50 can and will help young people thrive, to build a coalition of thousands of youth-serving partner organizations and communities that are interested in harnessing this talent, to change expectations about the meaning and possibilities in the second half of life, to create what we like to call a renewable resource as new generations get older. And lastly, to change the national narrative to show the reality of generational interdependence. Now that, we know, is a tall order. And we'd also like to let you know that each of you is a pioneer. The Generation to Generation campaign is only 5 months old. The Summer Challenge has just begun. And this is the first time we've designed a webinar to engage groups like yours. Considerable research, hard thinking, lots of talking with many people and ideas inspired the creation of the Generation to Generation campaign. For me, the idea of planting trees under whose shade we will never sit is particularly meaningful. Of course, throughout history, older people have guided those younger and planted seeds like this. So the generation to generation idea isn't something new, but what is new is that the demographic and longevity revolutions have dramatically increased both the number of people and the number of years during which we can do this. And because we understand what it takes to make large-scale social change, and we know that a concerted effort is needed to capture this renewable resource for our society to grow great, we created this five-year campaign. And it's a campaign rather than simply a program, because we can only do this with many people, many organizations, and many communities leaning in with us. Here are some of the organizations already involved as partners, each making a commitment to the idea that adults in the second half of life can make a significant contribution to helping young people succeed. Some, like the Village to Village Network and AARP, are helping us recruit older adults to become part of this effort. Others, like Big Brothers Big Sisters and Crisis Text Line, are asking older adults to step up and help them serve young people. Now to shift our focus to summer. Most of us think of summer as a time for fun, relaxation, creating special memories, perhaps with our own grandchildren. But for many kids in this country, especially for those in low-income communities, this is not the case. Just one example of many. is what happens over the summer to graduating high schoolers who have been accepted to college and are the first in their families to achieve this goal. Two out of three of these high school students end up failing to enroll, leaving only one on the path to gaining the college degree that is so important to succeed in life. If summer counseling and support had been available to them, experience shows that it could have made a difference, and perhaps all three would still be showing on this screen, ready to enroll in college. We're about to hear from experts why summertime, when school is out, is such an important time for the development of kids, beginning in the earliest grades, which is why, as this summer begins, we're joining with our partners to pursue the vision that all children and youth have access to high quality experiences that can help them succeed in college, career, and life. And we'd like to invite you to help us achieve this goal. To do that, I'm joined by four speakers who will go a bit deeper on why summer matters, explain what we mean by Gen to Gen Summer Challenge, and finally, introduce to you ways that you can participate. Our first guest is Matthew Boulay, who, after teaching in one of the poorest New York City neighborhoods, came to understand the serious consequences of summer learning loss. Matthew went on to found and lead the National Summer Learning Association, and we've asked him to join us to explain why he did that.
I'm Matthew Boulay, the founder and interim CEO of the National Summer Learning Association. We're a national nonprofit. We're based in Baltimore. Next year, we celebrate our 25th anniversary. So the evidence on summer learning loss is crystal clear. We have literally a mountain of research evidence that shows that most students in America, and certainly most of our most vulnerable students, experience a summer setback or summer slide. And the magnitude of summer learning loss is really pretty startling. You know, anywhere from 1 to 2 to 3 months of learning can be lost over the summer. You know, for many students, that loss occurs summer after summer after summer. And of course, it hits our most vulnerable students hardest. So our low-income students, in particular, students who don't have resources in the home or community to, you know, continue the learning that they achieved during the school year. You know, and so the evidence is clear. It's compelling, and it really begs for, I think, a concerted response across communities and across systems to support children. We always say that summer is the most unequal time in America, that we pour enormous resources, as we should, into supporting our children's learning and healthy development from September through May or June. But then for the most part, we step back for the summer months, June, July, and August. We step back from that commitment and don't support children in terms of public programming at any scale. And so it's a system, you know, that essentially of schooling that is on again, off again, on for 9 months, off for 3 months. And as I said, and as you would expect, you know, our most vulnerable students are the ones who experience the most loss. It's worth pointing out that much of the widening of the achievement gap that occurs from the early elementary grades through middle school and high school is caused not by what happens during the school year when kids are learning, but during the summer months when some kids are learning. More affluent children in particular, and some kids are falling back, lower income kids in particular. And so that those summer months are when the gap between haves and have-nots tends to widen. So we talk about summer learning and summer learning loss as issues of equity and issues of achievement.
Thank you, Matthew. What you said at the end, that the problem begs for a concerted response to support children, is what animates the Gen2Gen Summer Challenge. I'd like to now introduce my colleague, Gen2Gen team member, Aaron Larson, to build upon what you just heard from Matthew. Aaron, take it away.
Thank you, Phyllis. As Matthew shared, summer matters. And this summer, we have four focus areas that we are going to turn our attention to. They are learning, meals, jobs, and play. Besides summer learning loss, another issue our youth face during the summer is the lack of healthy meals. According to Feeding America, of the 22 million children who receive free or reduced-priced school meals during the school year, 5 out of 6 will not be able to access those meal programs during the summer due to a number of barriers. So alongside our partners, including Feeding America and USDA Food and Nutrition Service, we're working on increasing access to healthy meals this summer for our youth. Another issue is summer employment. The Pew Research Center tells us only 20% of 16 to 17-year-olds get a summer job, and that's less than half the level as recently as the year 2000. Many times it's not for the lack of the want of a summer job or for summer income, but rather a lack of preparation to know where to find these employment opportunities, and then how do you secure those? This summer, with the help of our partners, which include the Department of Labor, LA Chamber of Commerce, and the National Youth Employment Coalition, we're working to increase access to and support summer employment opportunities for youth. Lastly, this summer, we're focusing on increasing access to safe places to play. According to our partner Kaboom, only 1 in 4 children get 60 minutes of physical activity or active play every day. As play has decreased, obesity rates and behavioral and cognitive disorders have increased. Furthermore, our youth need to be able to engage in healthy play activities in places where they feel safe. From these focus areas, there's something each of us can do to help create better futures for youth this summer. So let's talk about how to get started. Here at Gen2Gen, we've created the Summer Challenge, and this really is an opportunity for all of us to make a positive impact in the lives of youth this summer. It's comprised of 3 different steps. The first step is to take a stand. This is all about raising awareness and inspiring change in your local community. The second step is to show up. This is where you'll have the opportunity to find local organizations to get involved with or browse other creative ways to make a difference on your own or with friends. We'll be exploring some of the tools and resources we have available for you later in this presentation. The third step is to share your moment. This is an opportunity to raise awareness about these summer gap issues and inspire others to join in. Let's dive a bit deeper into step 1, take a stand. In this step, we're asking you to contact your mayor to proclaim Summer Learning Day on July 13th, 2017. We have a proclamation created by the National Summer Learning Association and sample email language ready to go for you. We'll even help you locate where to send it. All you have to do is sign up, tailor the email language, and click send. With your help, we can reach 500 mayors just in time. Step 2 of the Gen2Gen Summer Challenge is all about showing up and getting involved. As Matthew shared earlier, summer is the most unequal time in America. We'd encourage you to choose one of the 4 focus areas that you're most passionate about impacting. Would you like to combat summer learning loss? Would you like to increase access to healthy meals, support summer employment opportunities for youth, or increase access to safe places to play? Choose one of these challenges. When you do that, and by entrusting us with your contact information, we'll be able to send you tools and resources that are tailored towards that summer issue that you are focused on making an impact. It also allows us to provide you with more information about these summer gap issues. And to help you along the way in your journey, we've gathered several resources and tools that you'll be able to use to jump in, to engage, and to make an impact. One is our Gen2Gen Summer Opportunity Finder. This is a directory of local resources that will help point you in the right direction within your community. Another is our featured opportunities from partners, and we'll dive a little deeper into that in a minute. And we also have your Lead Your Own Activity or DIY activities. The Gen2Gen Summer Opportunity Finder is powered by Volunteer Match, and what we're using it for is to help you find local opportunities to engage in these volunteer activities within your community this summer. And it doesn't have every activity that's going on in your local community, but it's a great place to start and search to see if there are some activities listed in your immediate area for which you can get involved with. Another resource that's available is actually through some of our local partners, including the Boys and Girls Clubs of America. One of the summer programs they're running this year is the Brain Gain Curriculum. And this is something they've had great success with. And to tell us more about that program and how you can get involved, we have a special guest today, Jamie Petway, who is the Senior Director of Educational Foundations at the Boys and Girls Clubs of America.
Summer Brain Gain actually launched in 2013, and this is our fifth year of implementation. Over the past 5 years, we've seen that we have not experienced any losses in reading or mathematics, which is wonderful. We're also excited because we've experienced some gains in mathematics for our fourth, fifth, and eighth graders. I can think of a couple of clubs in particular who had youth who didn't have access to summer enrichment programs as well as snacks. And because of Summer Brain Gain, they not only had access to academic support, but also snacks as well. And so with those stories, we've learned that some of the youth have had the opportunities to not experience hunger during summer, as well as go back to school prepared for the next school year. We have quite a few examples of those. As a volunteer, many of our volunteers express how rewarding the experience was. Number one, they had the opportunity to see the light bulb go off in a child's eyes. And it's an amazing thing when you have such a profound impact on a youth, particularly in such a sustained period of time. Our program runs from 6 to 10 weeks, depending on how long a club is open during summer. And to be able to meet a child and engage with them in such a meaningful or relevant way while also providing academic support is something that's invaluable. So we've heard things like, this was life-changing for me. I love seeing the light go off in Johnny's eyes when I engaged with him or we completed an activity. So because we have such a potpourri of opportunities in terms of activities and enrichment, engagement between volunteers, our club staff, and our youth, it makes it a very, very rewarding experience. I think one of the most important things to know about Boys and Girls Clubs of America in general is that we serve those who need us most, and that is America's youth. We do it from a global perspective. But what's most important about Summer Brain Gain is it's not where a volunteer would go into a club and expect to teach. It's actually an opportunity to engage and do hands-on activities. All too often, we miss opportunities to truly engage and model for our youth what our leaders of today look like in order for them to be appropriately prepared to lead us tomorrow. So I think this Gen2Gen opportunity gives us that chance to help bring those two together, to synergize, if you will. It is rewarding for both the Gen2Gen volunteers as well as our youth. So I'm really, really excited about it and so happy that we have this opportunity to come together.
Thank you, Jamie. One exciting fact about this Brain Gain curriculum is that it's being offered by over 1,000 Boys and Girls Clubs across the country. It's a 6 to 8 week session, and it's a great way to get involved and to show up for youth this summer. Another way to get involved is to lead your own activity. You can host your own block party. You can have a picnic or a barbecue. Lots of different ways to get involved. One of the ways you can get involved is to actually lead an assessment of what's needed in your community. And the National Summer Learning Association actually provides an assessment that you can use to help you identify those needs in your community. Another way to get involved is to contact local programs in your faith communities to get involved and volunteer. You could also advocate for more summer resources in your community by organizing an event or asking your mayor to sign a proclamation. Another opportunity to get involved is the National Summer Learning Day. And tell us more about that day in particular and how you can get involved is Laura Johnson, the VP of Communications for the National Summer Learning Association.
Hi, my name is Laura Johnson. I'm Vice President of Communications at the National Summer Learning Association, and we are committed to keeping kids learning healthy and safe every summer, ensuring that they return to school ready to soar. National Summer Learning Day is a national advocacy day that's hosted by the National Summer Learning Association. And this is really our chance to celebrate that learning happens anywhere, anytime, and that summers matter for young people. So for National Summer Learning Day, we invite communities, elected officials, educators, families, and students to really come together, spotlight what exciting things are happening in their communities, to also lift up the importance of why summers matter. Last year, we had over 1,100 events hosted across the country in many different communities. So the National Parks and Recreation Centers, we have libraries that are engaged in activities across the country. We have museums that host many activities. They have lots of discount nights for families. And so the activities across the country vary. We have even had one community host a 5K run, really kind of focusing on the importance of keeping bodies moving and active during the summer. Lots of communities also invite their mayors to come to, perhaps it's a story hour at a local library, or it might be something fun going on at a local museum. Summertime is also a time when many young people are looking to find nutritious meals, because we know that hunger does not take a vacation during the summer. And so there are lots of summer meal sites around the country, and so that's an opportunity to volunteer time at a local summer meal site. There's lots of ways for folks to get involved and to support our young people, not just during the school year, but through the critical summer months as well. So we're grateful for Gen to Gen for this partnership.
Thank you, Laura, for some great ideas and tips on how we can get involved in National Summer Learning Day. Now I'd like to move on to our third step of the Gen to Gen Summer Challenge, which is to share your moment. And again, this is a way for us to raise awareness about some of these summer issues that affect youth, inspire others to get involved, and to advocate for resources that help solve these issues. And the way to participate in this step is to capture your moment and then share it with us online. You can do that through Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, using the hashtag Gen2GenMoment. And that will automatically retrieve your moment. We'll be displaying these moments in our online gallery and sharing those with others through our platforms as well. And we also have some surprises during the summer. We'll be giving away hats and t-shirts and mugs, lots of Gen2Gen gear that will help inspire others to join along. We're also helping to fund a Gen2Gen summer event. It's so important that you share your moment so that we can raise awareness about these summer issues, we can inspire others to get involved, and we can advocate for resources that help solve these issues. Okay, so just to recap the summer challenge, we have step one, which is to take a stand. Step two is to show up, and that's where you're choosing to accept the challenge in one of the four areas of learning, meals, jobs, and play. And this is where you're getting involved. You are participating in an activity, whether this be through one of our partners, whether it's one in your local community that you found through our opportunity finder, or it's an activity that you are leading yourself through one of the ideas that was presented here today. Maybe it's an event on National Summer Learning Day. Lots of ways to get involved. And then the third step is to share your moment. And again, this is a way for us to raise awareness, to inspire others, and to advocate for more resources to solve these summer issues. Finally, I just want to thank you for having an interest in improving the lives of youth this summer. This taking the summer challenge is one great way to accomplish that, and we hope that you'll join us. Without further ado, I'd like to hand it back over to Phyllis to wrap up the presentation.
Thanks very much, Aaron. I'm glad to be back with you all to draw this presentation to a close with a few final thoughts. The co-founder of Head Start told us decades ago that every child needs at least one adult who is irrationally crazy about him or her. In the decades since, we have come to realize that even beyond this, young people need a web of steady and caring adults to support their path to success in life, and that each of us can become part of that web for children, for youth in our communities, as well as for doing that in our own families. Beyond summer, what we accomplish now this year can be the foundation for doing it again in 2018 and 2019, because you know what? We need to be in this for the long haul. We hope that this presentation has left you ready to say yes to the question, will you be part of the solution to the problems that summertime creates for the development of young people? And now we'd like to hear any of your questions, send many of you off to discuss it in your group, and to encourage you to please send us back the feedback questionnaire that we have asked you to complete. Thanks very much, and we hope that you'll be part of this Generation to Generation Summer Challenge 2017. Bye now.